Hi, this is Clara, and I'm glad you joined me for this guided sleep story. This episode aims to provide a peaceful and calming environment, blending storytelling, meditation, natural sounds, and soothing music to help you unwind and achieve restful sleep. Whether you have difficulty falling asleep, need a way to relax after a long day, this episode is designed to provide you with the perfect escape. A friend has invited you to stay at Firefly Farm and keep an eye on things while they're away. More than 2,000 species of firefly exist on every continent apart from Antarctica. Fireflies are very social and use their bioluminescent lights to communicate with each other. But artificial lights prevent fireflies from seeing each other's flashes. So, when you visit a remote place like Firefly Farm, it's very dark during the night time because there's no other light source for miles and miles. Before we begin, I'd like you to take a few moments to help you become more relaxed for the sleep story. Start by settling into a comfortable position and gently close your eyes. Allow your breath to carry you into relaxation with its natural rhythm. Bring your full attention to each inhale as your breath travels down into your lungs and expands your belly. Notice how your belly contracts when you exhale. When your breath moves back up through your lungs and out of your nostrils or mouth. Be present with your breathing for a while. And if your mind wanders away with a thought, emotion, or sensation that catches your attention, gently guide your awareness back. Now, let's start the sleep story. All the trees are bare in the mountains where you begin the journey. But the farther you travel on the road that unravels south through the mountains, the more the season shifts from winter to spring. The The farther you go, the warmer it becomes. And when the sun comes out, the sky turns from light gray to blue. And here, the branches of the trees start showing a slight tinge of green on the edges. Then, you cross over an invisible latitude into spring, where blossoms in shades of light purple and white flower on trees you've never seen before. And then, more miles down the road, you cross another invisible line where the sun blasts through a full forest canopy and neon shades from the brand new green are so dazzling you need to put on your sunglasses. When you arrive at the flatlands, bright pink wildflowers line both sides of the road in broad swaths. You pass fields with horses, donkeys, and cows and broken down barns. A pine forest with tall, straight trees lined in forever rows. A small house with a garden where an older man throws a ball for his dog to fetch. Your friend told you to look out for a large rectangular white stone marking the driveway on the right-hand side of the road, 56.4 miles after leaving Alba, the last town. And you almost don't see the white stone, so tangled as it is amongst the grass and the wild flowers. You turn right and head down a rocky driveway shrouded by a tangle of leafy branches from ancient oak trees. These giants have never known an axe. Storms or anything else. They're many hundreds of years old. Moss and ferns cover the trunks, and their branches support nests and birds and more birds. Sunlight spills through their canopy, And before long, you round the last corner and see Firefly Farm. You park the car, gather your bags, and walk up to the house. It's modest, with a tin roof and a large wraparound porch. You climb up the porch steps to the front door. The key is hidden under the corner of a doormat, printed with the words, "This must be the place." Your friend couldn't tell you how many generations of the family have called this home. There have been so many. And once inside the house, you feel the warm ambience of the place. And a sense of peacefulness and harmony emanating from the walls. You discover your bedroom next to the kitchen. The old brass bed is inviting. And you pause to admire the faded Persian rugs on the floor. But you leave your bag here and then head back outside through the back porch door. A couple of wood rocking chairs are in the middle of the deck. You sit down on one of them and absorb the view. Beyond the covered porch is a vast pond framed by water lilies. The water lily flowers are white, and the crystal clear clarity of the water suggests the pond is fed by an underground spring. The sun slips behind the ancient oak trees. And you watch the patch of the sky you can see turn from purple to an inky shade of blue. And then night falls. and all the night creatures start their chorus. And the water lily flowers close their blooms for the night. First of all, just two or three tiny green specks appear, winking through the trees. Then, slowly, more and more sparks twinkle until parts of the old oak trees light up with a green glow. You've never seen so many fireflies gathered in one spot. They're glittering constellations. Fly out above the pond, reflecting and swirling, lighting up the lily pads. Then some fireflies drift over your head and land on the porch like tiny green embers. Their display lasts for a long time. Then, gradually, the fireflies drift away deeper into the forest and finally disappear altogether into the darkness. And now, you're alone in the dark, with the trees, the old house, and the sounds of the night. There's no moon. So when you shift your gaze again to the sky, you notice how the bright light from the stars has replaced the lights from the fireflies. The warm evening ambience, the comfort of the rocking chair, and the gentle sound of the creatures in the forest combine like a soothing tonic to make you drowsy. So you close your eyes. Lean back and rock gently to sleep.